Anne was enjoying the excitement of the various preparations, but under it all she carried a little heartache. She was, in a sense, losing her dear old chum. Diana's new home would be 2 miles from Green Gables, and the old constant companionship could never be theirs again. Anne looked up at Diana's light and thought how it had beaconed to her for many years, but soon it would shine through the summer twilights no more. 2 big, painful tears welled up in her gray eyes. Oh, she thought, how horrible it is that people have to grow up and marry and change. End of chapter 28. Chapter 29. Diana's Wedding. After all, the only real roses are the pink ones, said Anne as she tied white ribbon around Diana's bouquet in the westward-looking gable at Orchard Slope. They are the flowers of love and faith. Diana was standing nervously in the middle of the room, arrayed in her bridal white, her black curls frosted over with the film of her wedding veil. Anne had draped that veil, in accordance with the sentimental compact of years before. "It's all pretty much as I used to imagine it long ago, when I wept over your inevitable marriage and our consequent parting," she laughed. "You are the bride of my dreams, Diana, with the lovely misty veil, and I am your bridesmaid. But alas, I haven't the puffed sleeves, though these short lace ones are even prettier. Neither is my heart wholly breaking, nor do I exactly hate Fred." "We're not really parting, Anne," protested Diana. "I'm not going far away. We'll love each other just as much as ever. We've always kept that oath of friendship we swore long ago, haven't we?" "Yes, we've kept it faithfully. We've had a beautiful friendship, Diana. We've never marred it by one quarrel or coolness or unkind word, and I hope it will always be so. But things can't be quite the same after this. You'll have other interests. I'll just be on the outside. But such is life, as Mrs. Rachel says. Mrs. Rachel has given you one of her beloved knitted quilts of the tobacco-stripe pattern, and she says when I'm married she'll give me one, too." "The mean thing about your getting married is that I won't be able to be your bridesmaid," lamented Diana. "I'm to be Phil's bridesmaid next June, when she marries Mr. Blake, and then I must stop, for you know the proverb, 3 times a bridesmaid, never a bride," said Anne, peeping through the window over the pink and snow of the blossoming orchard beneath. "Here comes the minister, Diana." "Oh, Anne," gasped Diana, suddenly turning very pale and beginning to tremble. "Oh, Anne, I'm so nervous. I can't go through with it. Anne, I know I'm going to faint."
"If you do, I'll drag you down to the rainwater hogshead and drop you in," said Anne unsympathetically.
"Cheer up, dearest. Getting married can't be so very terrible when so many people survive the ceremony. See how cool and composed I am, and take courage. Wait till your turn comes, Miss Anne." "Oh, Anne, I hear father coming upstairs. Give me my bouquet. Is my veil right? Am I very pale?" "You look just lovely. Di, darling, kiss me goodbye for the last time. Diana Barry will never kiss me again." "Diana Wright will, though. There. Mother's calling. Come."